Capital Combat Parley. My name is Garmamie. I am joined by Pat Cooligan. How you doing, Pat?
I'm great, sir. How you doing?
I'm good. I know you're a big fan of Jocko Willink, yes?
Absolutely, yeah. Big Jocko fan. Met him in July in Austin, Texas, and got to spend a couple days live with him at his event. It was an awesome experience.
What did you learn from that exchange in that event? If you can sum it up in a few words.
Just more of the book. He just recaps the book, and he does it in an excellent way. Super articulate guy, very direct. You know, he talks about extreme ownership, obviously, and, you know, it's a concept that most people in reality struggle with. They can't, you know, really own very much of their own actions, and I'm a big believer that, you know, the bulk of the problems we have, you know, we're responsible for those. And I think there's too many people out there looking to point the finger and blame other people. And Jocko makes you understand real quick, you're going nowhere in life if that's your mentality. So it was an awesome experience.
Tell us, for people who don't know who this Jocko is, who he is and his background and so on and so forth.
So Jocko Willink gained a lot of fame in the mid-2000s, 2005, 2006, during the Battle of Ramadi in Iraq. He was the commanding officer of SEAL Team Bruiser. And, you know, the Battle of Ramadi was widely regarded as some of the most ferocious urban combat in modern day warfare. You know, we had an Academy Award winning movie, you know, with American Sniper, directed by Clint Eastwood. And that featured Chris Kyle, who met his unfortunate demise several years later in civilian life. And Jocko was his commanding officer, and he actually delivered the eulogy, you know, when Chris Kyle passed away. So, you know, there's a lot of history there. There's Mikey Mansour. Today being September 29th is the anniversary of Mike Mansour's death. And yeah, there's a lot of background to these SEALs. They have some CrossFit workouts named after them, like the Murph and stuff. So, you know, it was a really moving event, and I got to go to Chris Kyle's grave in Austin. And yeah, it was just something I was very proud to do, and it made me a better entrepreneur for sure.
That's interesting, because he's definitely impacted and influenced many people in various aspects of business, including martial arts. Would that be fair to say?
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, he's a Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu black belt. He owns a gym in San Diego, California. You know, he trains every day. I don't know anybody that trains as much as him one way or another, not just necessarily Jiu-Jitsu, but he's an inspirational guy, and I'm a competitive guy. And when I look out there, I don't like to see people better than me at something, and there's a whole lot he's better than me, so it gives me someone to chase. He's inspirational for sure.
What is the current state of, from your perspective, what is the current state of jiu-jitsu and martial arts in the Ottawa-Gatineau area? From your point of view as a business owner, and from the bigger, wider point of view as a community?
You know, I think we're going through some unfortunate times here in Ontario, given the state of Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. There's a PSO status. So right now, you know, there's not a lot of tournaments. And then, you know, we're seeing a lot of evolution in the sport. You know, we see teams growing, changing, fragmenting. And I mean, that's the natural history, and a lot of people struggle with change. And but it's the natural evolution of things. And, you know, I'll use the Jocko Willink analogy. Every time there is change, or there is controversy, or there is contentiousness, you know, in the words of Jocko, he would say, you know, good. It's an opportunity for us to get better. It's right. An opportunity for me, my instructors, and my team, you know, to up their game. And, you know, I live and breathe jiu-jitsu. It's... Right. You know, everything, I'm back in Canada for a couple weeks. I've got like 9 seminars lined up in the next 14 days.
Wow, so where's this? All over Canada? Or?
Yeah, so I mean, I'm doing a host of different seminars, not just jiu-jitsu, but I'm going to be in Peterborough, Kitchener-Waterloo, North Bay, Sudbury, Saskatoon, Lethbridge, Calgary, Kingston.
Canada-wide tour.
Yeah, Canada-wide tour in the next couple weeks. So,
speaking of tour, weren't you hanging out with your homeboy Renzo in Finland?
Yeah, I was just over.
Tell us about that.
Oh, okay. Well, that's awesome. You know, obviously, I'm a big fan of Renzo. I've been with Renzo since shortly after 9/11. And I got my purple, brown, and black belt from Renzo. You know, I named my son Renzo. And, you know, I did these things just because of how he's positively, you know, impacted my life. My relationship with Renzo is something, you know, really near and dear to me. Pretty much every time he's fought since I've been on the team, with the one exception of when he fought Frank Shamrock. I was in Guam with my team of MMA fighters, but I've been out at all his fights, when he fought Carlos Newton, when he fought Matt Hughes in Abu Dhabi. And yeah, I met all his fights, and you know, I got to spend some time with him. I was Matt's side. I was able to speak to him right when he got off the mat. You know, he's 50 years old, and again, talk about an inspiration. I think a lot of people would be, you know, I wish a lot of people were lucky enough to have an instructor like him. He's been incredibly giving with me. You know, he's changed my life, and you know, that's, I think, the source of the endearment I have for him.
One last question. What, it seems like today you've got something you want to say. Is there something you want to say? Beyond this great interview, is there something else you want to share? Are you going to tell us about how you're going to be competing at the next kickboxing event?
No. You know, I think for me, I would just...
You're going to be competing in mixed martial arts. Is that it?
No. I'm pretty safe to say with 5 kids under 9, I'm retired.
Man, how do you do it? 5 kids and running all these businesses. Like, how do you manage your time? Is it extreme discipline or extreme ownership? What?
I think it's a bit of both. But I think the reality is, I think everybody who's in a relationship and in a marriage counts themselves lucky. But, you know, in my case, my wife... I think, you know, in reality, in many ways, she's the unsung hero of Awama. Mm. I left a couple weeks ago, and by the time I return home after my seminar tour, I will have been gone from my home in Orlando for 31 days. And my wife is at home. She's got no nanny. You know, we immigrated to the U.S. in April. She has no support. You know, we have some friends, but, you know, not that she can really. So she's winging this on her own. Mm. And, you know, I'd like to give her props, because I'm able to do what I do because of my wife. And then in terms of something to say, you know, I just want to say, like, I live and breathe the martial arts community. But above and beyond that, I live and breathe the Ottawa, the national capital martial arts community. I started doing jiu-jitsu with John Terry at the Terry Jiu-Jitsu Dojo. I was 5 years old, 1979. Mm. I opened Awama in 2003. So I've been a part of this community for a long time. You know, I would say this, Awama is here to stay. You know, Awama is going to be going through some exciting changes that I think some people might find misleading in the next 12 to 18 months.
And care to elaborate on that?
Well, we're going to be, you know, changing things up. We might see a couple different locations. We might open, we might close a couple locations, and we're going to be basically building a lighter, more agile business platform. And, you know, we're in it to win it. This is what I would say in terms of the combat sports industry, in terms of like fighting arts. Mm-hmm. We've been leading the way for the last 15 years. I don't think anybody should be naive enough to think that that's going to change anytime soon. I'm pretty confident in saying the next UFC fighter out of Ottawa is going to be out of Ottawa Academy of Martial Arts. You know, we recently signed Ashley Nichols to Invicta, you know, which we know is a big deal. And, you know, in terms of all the competition out there, I'd say, guys, you know, bring your A game, because, you know, we've been here for a long time. We're going to continue to be here for a long time, and we welcome the challenge. And it's something that me and my staff are looking very forward to.
Thank you very much. And well, actually, one last question. How's that American life? America.
Yeah, America. I'll tell you one thing. There's some crazy things going on down there in the U.S. Number one, I live in Florida. That's a pretty Republican state. A lot of good old boys down in Florida. And here's the number one quick fact. If everybody in Canada thinks all the Americans hate Donald Trump, they're dead wrong. Because a lot of people love Donald Trump. And, you know, being a Canadian, that was a bit of a culture shock. You know, what we see on CNN and stuff. And, you know, people knock the American medical system because you got to pay for it. We had a bit of a family emergency down there, let me tell you. You know what? We got to pay, and their structure is pretty messed up. But
you mean to tell me the OHIP didn't work?
No, the OHIP did not work. But let me tell you, I'm loving life down in Florida. And, you know, I think I'm fortunate enough I get to travel all over the world. And let me tell you, I think in Canada, we're extremely lucky to say it's one of the best countries in the world. I think there's no doubt about that. I am Canadian. I'm proud to be Canadian. I'll always be proud. But I can tell you with my experience in the U.S. the last 6 months and some of the gratitude and the way Orlando has opened its arms to me, my family, my business platform, I'm going to be really proud in the not too distant future to be an American. And again, that's just one more evolution. And that's one more way that Awama, I believe, is truly ahead of the curve in the martial arts industry.
Obviously, if you're moving down south and expanding, that's a big, significant move. All the best to you. Thank you very much for speaking to us, and we hope to speak to you again.
Thank you, guys.